it's Christmas Eve. No one should be alone at Christmas.
What did you say your name was?
Madge. Madge Arwell.
If there's ever anything that I can do for you, let me know.
How?
I don't know. Make a wish, that usually works.
Does it?
Well, it did for me. You're here, aren't you?
When's Father coming back?
For Christmas, like he always does. Now, hurry up and think of something.
But we're going to Uncle Digby's house. Will he be there?
He will, won't he, Mother? Daddy will be there.
Of course he will.
See? Now, have you thought of anything?
Yeah.
Count of three, then. Make a wish. One, two, three!
Hi, everybody. Welcome to The Law and the Promise, the channel where we talk about principle, law, truth. You know, that's uncorruptible, absolute, certain, sure, true. Never changes, always working, works for all, never deviates, you know, like gravity. And how it affects you. And these are the universal laws of mind. Now, the question was asked at Patreon about a comparison and a contrast of my point of view of the 12 laws of mind versus what others have said about the 12 laws of mind. So, I have read a billion of them and come to my conclusions. Okay, and my conclusion is always to point out the point of view. To just look at it, you know. So my point of view is, one, they're not laws of the universe. That's man thinking. Okay? Men think like that. There are no laws of the universe because there is no universe. It's a physical thing. It's man thinking. Okay? It's part of the mask. Okay? So you're in this, some people call it a stream of thought. All right? But what it is really, you're in the heart of the essence. You are the essence. And you're the presence that was made within the essence. So the essence could express its beauty and sing. It must sing. It wants to sing. It's going to sing. Okay? Everything is singing. This is why the Psalms are really powerful. And that's, for lack of a better term, it's to help man, okay? Every single one of them. Because this is what was being said by the one who fell. And men came out of her. And because of this, you know, these psalms help make that bridge between the two. And because one is all good, and one is physical, you know, and spirit can't see the physical. The physical can't see the spirit. Okay? The two are not alike. Okay? And it's reconciling these two. And this is done through the man. And it's like you're in a blender being emulsified. And that can't happen until your spirit is broken as a man. Or you freely give it up. And usually you will not freely give it up until you've had enough pain and suffering. And that's it. You just can't stand it anymore. Might as well come in. That's how you feel. Okay. There's no hope in your mind. if that's it, you know, I've done it, I've tried, I've lost, I've made fortunes, I've lost fortunes. Yeah, I guess, you know, what the fuck? What the fuck? I'm not going down like this. This ship is not going down. Okay. And what's going to keep it up? The essence. The essence of it. Because it's not real. Only the essence is real. Okay. That's it. We're one great big happy kid. And this is what the Bible tells you. Okay. Now, everybody else is giving their point of view of what the Bible is saying. And the majority of them will take this verse or that verse. And that's to help, you know, cut it down because you're talking to men. But some of them highly encourage you to go read it. Go read the whole psalm. Go read Romans this or Matthew that, you know. And before I go any further, read it. You know, because it will really help you understand what this verse I'm about to read is saying in your own way. Because you can take a horse to water. I can tell you what I think, but I can't make you drink. I can't make you understand. I can't make you contemplate. I can't make you think about these things. Only you can decide whether to do that or not. You know, I highly encourage, you know, everyone to look at many points of view because really they're all the same point of view. They really are. They're all saying the same thing differently. Okay, and this is the man mask of humanity. There's no humanity. Okay, so you have to keep insisting that you have to keep persisting. And this is the beauty of understanding in these Psalms. These are in the Bible itself. The Bible is God's word. Okay, it's His word. That means it's a promise to you. And you don't say these words with, oh Lord, help me, you know, get me to the still waters. Or no, it's no, you promise. It's right here. Here's your word. Your word is truth. Your word is principle. There's nothing but God. The pestilence is after my ass. You promised me, you know. Thank you, Father, for blessing me with what I need now. That's what that song is about. And every one of them has, you know, something to address, whatever. And some of the greatest ones, you know, are all inclusive, like 46 and 91. These are great, you know. And then Psalm 82 is, hey, you guys, you do understand this. When are you going to stop, you know, doing your little rituals and stop thinking like men and start, you know, helping out with the orphans and the widows. Meaning these are people who don't have any guidance. They don't have a consciousness to help them. Okay? They're running around like chickens with their heads cut off. Help them. They're good. Okay? That's what it means in that psalm. That's what Psalm 82 is. If you know about this stuff, pray for your brother. You'd want him to pray for you. Yeah, so there's only one. Okay? There's only one. Just think there's individuals. So if you can realize, recognize the one in all of it, and, you know, people say that we're all interconnected. They were all synced. They were all, you know, whatever it takes for you to understand it. Okay. So my perception is that these have been scattered throughout time and space in words. in the different stories, and that as long as you think like a man, you fall under the 12 karmic laws. When you begin to rise above that, then law one and two break off like a rocket ship, you know, and leave behind the fuselage. Yeah, that stuff's gone now. And now, okay, now you're taking off into the law of love and grace, the law of one. It's all perfect harmony. It's all beautiful. It's all lovely. All is well. I'm in the mind of God. Nothing can touch me. I'm in his imagination. I'm having the time of my life. Can't fool me. You know, I know what's going on here. You know, but it's a sincere, flippant thinking. You have to really mean it from your heart. You really do know. You really do understand. You know, God gave a man his imagination. And man ran off with it. And she's running around like, you know, poor thing, giving to this mental aberration that she loves. And she is begging for help for herself and her children. Because her children did listen. And her children did receive it. The soul. Not all. But she's been teaching them all along. Discern, look. You know, and they're like, nobody thinks like that. Do you think like that? Honestly, she's been guiding. She's the Immaculate Heart. She wants you to come home. You can't come home until your heart is immaculate. And it already is. If you're a man with a heart of gold, then you're not a man. That's all you have to do. Stop being John Smith. Okay? There is no John Smith. It's just one great big happy kid. And if you can just see that everywhere, if you can just know that God is the tree, you love the essence of the tree, not the tree. If you love the tree, then you're a pagan. You love the essence of someone. Okay? You don't love them because they got a big wanker and big titties. You know? This is what it's saying. It's the essence. It's the essence. You know, like attracts like. It's the essence. And everyone has a spark. You just have to grow it. Okay? You have to grow your soul. That's what you're doing. You've been given the spark. Now you have to grow your soul. You have to believe in it. And that leads to knowing. And that leads to you being the numero uno all around. Because you're just having the time of your life in the mind of God. It's all good. Yeah, it's all good. Nothing can hurt you. That's why you laugh in the face of adversity. That can't be. You know, during the day, you're the kid. You be respectful. Okay? You know you can do things and you don't use your name except wisely and judiciously. Okay? You don't give your love, your attention to just anyone. If it's mental, you don't. And if you have, then you forgive it to get it off of you. Because it doesn't behoove you or anyone else for it to be around. Let it go scurry off. The lights come on and like a roach, they scurry off. I don't know if that helps. That is my point of view of them. I know you're going to live in the karmic laws until you come to this understanding. And then you rise up. And it really is like a rocket ship. And you leave those behind. Okay? And now you're in the law of love and grace. Okay? And you just think about spiritual things, not mental things like you were before. And we call it a mental diet because we begin as men. So you have to, you know, this is what the men diet's going to be until it changes to the spiritual. Which is not really thinking at all. Just enjoying. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. And thank you. Thank you for being you.
No stars to light the way, Match. There was one. There was you.
What is it?
I don't know. But it's all we've got. We can follow it.
Magyar world who flew a whole forest through the time vortex, plus one husband. He did it again, Madge. He followed you home. Look what you can do. Mother Christmas.
Madge! What am I doing here?
It's Christmas Day, my love. Where else would you be?
Christmas Day? How?
We took a shortcut.
Happy crying. Humany womany.